Hello, hola, bonjour, ni hao, hello honey, which I believe is Essex, well, welcome and a very Merry Christmas to you all. Well, what a year it's been, and I suppose we weren't expecting that to happen. But the brilliant news is you still get an OXIDION Christmas special, which I'm sure the next 15 to 20 minutes will make up for all of this year.
The speakers are not working.
We would first like to say a massive thank you. The response to our YouTube account was amazing, and it's always lovely to see that all the time and effort our actors, lighting crews, sound crew, and everyone in between fit into our shows and DVD footage pays off and does its job to entertain you. Next, we'd like to tell you that everything you're going to see tonight was filmed with correct restrictions at the time of filming. For example, it's currently Sunday the 1st of November, and yesterday was Halloween. But as you can see, we've skipped Halloween here, and have decided to spend the next 2 months filming and editing. Not only that, but we spent the last month getting the running order sorted, composing music, choreographing dances, writing scripts, making props, making costumes, building and finding set locations, and much, much more. Now, some of you may be wondering what's happened to the live-action film of Coraline that we've promised. But with the recent news of a second lockdown and the uncertainty of the next few months, we've decided to do an easier approach to bring some entertainment to you this Christmas. On that note, I'd like to personally thank Clara, whose preferred name is now Robyn, who's dedicated an immense amount of their time to film Coraline. They had an 8-hour film production day with me, and it would be a crime not to use the footage. So once again, thank you very much, Robyn, and you'll be seeing that later on in the show. Now, even though you're not in the theatre this year, we still wanted to make our show inclusive. So you're going to see multiple performances tonight, and once you've seen all of them, you can vote for your favourite. Voting ends on midnight of the 1st of January 2021, and you'll find out the winner in our next show back here in the cabin. So, without further ado, let's begin OXIDION's Christmas Hamper special with a dazzling, elegant, and quite beautiful performance from Lucy Quinn.
As old as time, true as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least. Both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast, ever just the same, ever a surprise, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. As old as time, tune as old as song, bitter, sweet, and strange, finding you can change, learning you were wrong. Certain as the sun, rising in the east, tell us all. prime, beauty and the Beast.
A stunning piece there from Lucy Quinn. If you want to vote for Lucy and the Beast, all information is down below. But remember, you can't vote until you've seen all of the acts tonight. Next up, we go quite a few months back and into broad daylight with a performance from Robyn Burthoud as we go exploring with Coraline Jones. Daylight now, and it's 5 days until Christmas here. It's such a shame that we couldn't carry on filming for Coraline, but we'll be seeing more clips from that later on in the show. So if you want to vote for Coraline's exploration, all the details are down below. But remember, voting does not open until the end of the show. So next up, we're going even further back now, further back than the filming of Coraline, and we're going to go to the very, very start of October with a piece from Olivia Barshell called Sometimes Live, Don't Want to Be Happy.
Sometimes I don't want to be happy. Don't hold it against me. If I'm down, just leave me there, let me be sad. Sun's up, I already want to lay down. Friends calling, I ain't really trying to go out.
No.
Don't want to get dressed up to pretend.
No.
I could lie and say I'm fine, maybe you'll stop calling then. I've got chips on my shoulder, only getting older. So I keep to myself, ain't trying to complain, just don't want to explain it. But sometimes I don't want to be happy. Don't hold it against me. If I'm down, just leave me there, let me be sad. Sometimes I just want to be lonely. Don't need you to hold me. If I'm low, you don't need to care, let me be sad. What's the matter with that?
Oh, the competition is already on fire. If you want to vote for Sometimes Live, Don't Want to Be Happy, the information is down below. And remember, voting doesn't open until the end of the show. Okay, next up we've got a submission from Lucy Gregory, singing Jingle Bell Rock.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime and jingle bell time. Dance dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square in the frosty air. One horse sleigh, giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet, jingle up around the clock, mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime in jingle bell time, dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
Piece there from Lucy Gregory. If you want to vote for Lucy's Jingle Bell Rock, all of the information is at the top of the screen, but remember voting doesn't open until the end of the show. So you're probably wondering why my name always appears so many times in the end credits, and how does one person do all of that? Well, I'm going to tell you the truth, it's not all me. I do have seven other people that help me out. For the first time ever, you're going to get to meet all seven of them.
One day more, another day, another destiny, this never-ending road to Calvary. These men who seem to know my crime will surely come a second time. One day
I
more,
I did not live until today.
How can I live when we are parted? One day more,
tomorrow you
yet with you my world has started.
One more day,
will we ever meet
again? One more day,
I was meant to be with you.
What a life I'm living,
and I swear I will.
One day more,
watch them run amok, catch them as they fall. Never know your luck when there's a frame for all. Here a little dip, there a little touch. Most of them are gone, so they won't miss much.
My place is here, my I fight with you. Tomorrow is the judgment day. Tomorrow is the star.
Then. Well, if you want to vote for me, that's right, all information is at the bottom of the screen. Okay then, we're going to get a little bit serious now, and with a subject that many people seem to have forgotten about because of COVID-19. But unfortunately, it's not gone away and it's still a big issue in today's society. That's right, it is the dreaded climate change. And we just wanted to remind you to keep doing your parts to save our planet. And here with an interesting video about climate change is a piece by Coral Brown. It's called Coral and the Climate Change. Now, I need to carry on setting up for the next scene. Roll the VT.
You had plenty money, 1922. You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too. You're sitting here wondering what it's all about. You ain't got no money, they won't put you out. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too. What it's all about. You ain't got no money, they won't put you out. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too.
A telling piece there from Coral. If you want to vote for Coral and the climate change, all information is down below. And remember, voting doesn't open until the end of the show.
And I did tell you that it wasn't me that did it all on my own. Yes, I do have 7 other ghost me's that live in my cabin. But next up, we're going to look from another clip from Coraline. It's set in the magic garden scene, and where better to film a magical garden scene than in the garden. Now that really was a magical garden. Unfortunately, you can't vote for that one as it was not made by one particular person. But from one set of magic to the next, we're going to take you back to Erindale, where last year we visited for our Frozen Panto and promised to bring it back to you next year. But unfortunately, no one was quite expecting to go into a pandemic. But here, as the new starring role is Elsa, take it away, Shayne Taylor. That really was different. I believe you can see Shayne's debut in Frozen, the West End musical, next year. he's not going to be in that for some reason. If you want to vote for Shayne, all the information is up above. Now, still to come,
a submission from Robyn Burthoud. Some more clips from Coraline. My Comedy Dance. And a submission from Harold in his urban exploration.
We're going to have a short interval now, so go and grab yourself a drink, go grab yourself some food, and we'll see you in a few minutes.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back. I hope you're all ready for the second half of the show. And I'd just like to first point out my organisation skills. Because over the past 2 months, when I've been filming the video links, I was wearing the exact same clothes. So if you want to vote for Sometimes in the Climate Change, all the information is up above. Down below, but remember, voting doesn't open until the end of the show. Yes, and voting does not open until the end of the show. Apart from for this round, this is now a separate competition for artwork only. Any videos after and before this are not part of this competition. They are part of the performance competition. This is for art only. So what you need to do for the next 3 to 4 minute section is get out your phone, face it at the device you're watching this on and open your camera roll and take a picture of the QR code that will appear on the screen now. Okay, once that's done, you should see a page with numbers 1 to 15 on it. This is the voting page, and once you see all of the art submissions, you can vote for your favourite. Okay, first up at 001 is a drawing of an eyeball. After this one at 002 is a beautiful Christmas card. And next, with 003, is a digitally made photo. Next, at 004, is 2020 in a nutshell. Up next, at 005, is this piece of artwork. And next, at 006, is this drawing of graffiti work. Coming up at 007 is this drawing of Santa. And at 008 is this amazing computer drawn photo. And I believe we have a video of how it was made. A really amazing piece there. Next up, coming in at 009, is another Christmas card. After that, at 010, is a painting of the Grinch. Coming in at 011 is a pencil drawing of Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon. Coming in at 012 is this piece of art. Coming in at 013 is this collage. And next up at 014 is this pencil portrait. And lastly at 015 is another Christmas card. You can vote as many times as you like for this competition, but please make sure you go to the right website. The QR code will appear again on the screen now. That is the QR code for the art competition only. Let's quickly have a recap. Okay, let's get back to the performing arts competition now. We're going to show you another clip from Coraline. This is Coraline's Doll. I loved making the Coraline doll for that scene, and we tried to keep as true to the film as possible for making that. So if you want to vote for the Coraline doll, all information is up above. Okay, next we're going to do something very different now. This piece is actually going to be educational, and it's all about history. Take it away, Harold. Thank you very much for that educational piece, Harold. If you want to vote for Harold, all of the information is down below. And remember, voting doesn't open until the end of the show. Next up, we're going to show you all of our comedies that were sent in to us now, but we're going to start off with a comedy I made at the very start of Lockdown 1 that was never released to you. It's a parody of Little Britain.
Britain, 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 cultural capital of the world, the Sistine Chapel, British, Mozart Brentwood, British, the Great Wall of China, British, but none of that stuff would have been invented were it not for the people of Britain, the men, the women, the boys and the girls, the LGBT, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, and Z community. Watch us wreck the mic. Watch us wreck the mic.
And welcome to Catchphrase. Let's meet our contestants. First up today, we have Dave. Dave is from Surrey. Next up, we have Wendy. Wendy is from East Croydon. And last but not least, We have Vicky. It's from Yeah But No But Yeah But No But Yeah But No But Yeah But No London or something or nothing. So, Vicky, tell us a bit about yourself.
Yeah, but no, but yeah, but no, but yeah, because I live at home with Shirley, and she might be my mum, or she might be Amy's sister, or she could be both. But anyway, she is a well unfair, because this one time she grounded me for like 15 minutes, because I went down to Baskin Robbins, yeah, because Kristen had well got a Saturday job there, and I told him to give me all the money in the till, and then I shat in the milk truck chip.
And what about school?
Yeah, I went there once.
You went there once?
Yeah, I did math or something or nothing, and histography and biometry, and what's that one where they speak a funny language and you don't really understand what they're saying?
French?
No, English.
Okay, and what brought you here today?
A bus.
No, I meant what interested you in coming on the show, or did you just take some magic mushrooms and accidentally sign up?
Oh my god, that is like well out of order, because I only done drugs like once for like 8 years, but apart from that, I ain't really nothing or nothing. If you want to get someone got, it should be Kelly Baker, because she keeps saying really nasty things in front of my back, because she is a wild jealous, because she really, really fancies Dean Morris, and he did me up the wrong un around the back of Dunkin' Donuts. But I don't even fancy him, so I don't know what our problem is. I'm not a slag.
If you want to vote for A Very Little Britain, then all of the information is down below. But remember, voting doesn't open until the end of the show. Okay, next up, we're going to go for a submission from Robyn. It's a commercial called Demon Be Gone.
Are you tired of hearing the endless screams of the damned?
Yeah.
Are you ready to purge the souls of the unworthy?
I think so.
Are you tired of sleepless nights with endless whispers?
What?
Then try our new product, Demon Be Gone. It can do anything from killing demons to killing demons. See this possibly possessed cat? Well, now you don't have to. Don't rest in peace, possibly possessed pussycats.
The spray contains special chemicals which will create a vicious reaction within the abomination. This reaction will then make the demon slip into the void, and who knows what will happen after that.
The good news is that it is completely safe for any living life forms. You can even use it on children. It's that safe. Now go to the shops today and buy some Demon Be Gone.
Warning. Demon Be Gone has not been tested for any form of contact or consumption. If you experience any adverse effects, see a doctor or priest immediately.
For when you got to get rid of those demons.
If you like that commercial, all information to vote for it is at the bottom of your screen. And next up is a comedy dance by me, River Deep, Mountain High.
When I was a little girl,
everywhere.
to vote for my comedy dance, all of the information is at the bottom of your screen, but remember, voting isn't open until the end of the show. Now, as some of you know, we have our very own phantom that hides in the shadows, lurks behind the curtain. And yes, it is the dreaded James! For the first time ever, you're going to get to see him as he sent us in a cycle video that he made last week.
James from the James's cycle class, run by the Batty cycle classes and Batty's health club. So, today we will be using the challenge bike. So, if you'd like to get onto your bikes, it is also recommended for health and safety notices. As you can see, cycling for too long can cause dehydration, and if you ever get dehydration, you should have a drink before and after cycling. So I'm just going to have mine now. And also, if it does come with a fan wheel there, but if it is not functioning properly, it is recommended that you have a fan with you. So, today we will be cycling with one way or another, and this is routine one. So, if I click play. You want it on the lowest setting. Cycle forwards or backwards, it doesn't really matter, it will let you go either way. Also, a safety notice. If you notice that your wire is hanging on the wheel, can you remove it? Scary. If you want to vote for James's cycle class, all of the information is at the top of your screen. And that's it. That is all of the acts tonight, which means the vote is now open. You can vote by the website or by email.
To vote for Lucy and the Beast, via the website is O1, via email is DO1. To vote for Coraline's Exploration via the website is O2 and via email is AO1. To vote for Sometimes Liv Don't Want to Be Happy via the website is O3 and via email is MO1. To vote for Jingle Bells via the website is O4, via email is MD01. To vote for One Day More via the website is O5 and via email is MO2. To vote for Coral's Climate Change via the website is O6 and via email is MO3. To vote for Show Yourself via the website is O7, via email is MO4. To vote for Coraline's Doll via the website is 1-3 and via email is AO5. To vote for Harold's Exploration via the website is 09 and via email is AO2. To vote for Very Little Britain via the website is 1-1, via email is AO4. To vote for Demon Be Gone via the website is 10, via email is AO3. To vote for River Deep Mountain High via the website is 12, via email is DO3. To vote for James's cycle class via the website is 14 and via email is AO6. If voting via the website, please make sure you put your full name and do not vote for yourself, otherwise your vote will not count. To get to the website, please open up your phone, open up your camera roll, face it at the device you're watching this on, and the QR code will appear on the screen now. If the QR code is not working for you, there is a link in the comments below. And if neither of those work, please do not hesitate to contact us at oxidion.theatre@gmail.com. And any other contact points will be in the end credits. And now, to see us out from her new debut album, Gaffney and Me, it is the one, the only, Natalie Cassidy!
I don't want a lot for Christmas.
Well, yeah.
There's probably just one thing I need.
I want it.
Now, I don't care about the presents.
Do not.
Underneath my Christmas tree.
How do you want them? Come and tell us.
I just want you for my arms.
Oh, yeah.
More than you could ever know.
Oh, you can tell me that.
Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas is you.
I want the Gaffney, baby. Welcome to Oxford. Here you go, baby.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. Woo! There is just one thing I need. And I don't care about my presents underneath the Christmas bush. I don't need to hang my stockings. They're upon the fireplace. Santa Claus will make me happy.
And
the toy on Christmas Day. I just want you for my own.
Yeah.
More than you can tell
me.
Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas is
you.
I won't ask for much this Christmas. I won't even wish for stars. I'm just gonna keep on waiting underneath the camel toe. I won't make a list and send it to the North Pole for Saint Nick. I won't even stay awake to hear those magic amazing lyrics. 'Cause I just want you here tonight, holding on to me so tight. What more can I do? Baby, all I want for Christmas is you. Gaffney, wow. And all the lights are shining so brightly everywhere. And the smell of Natalie as her gas has filled the air. And everyone is singing, wow, yeah. I hear those sleigh bells ringing. Santa, won't you please be the one I really need? Won't you please be the Gaffney to me? Oh, I don't want a lot for Christmas. This is all I'm asking for. I just want to see my Dean Gaffney standing right outside my door. Oh, I just want you for my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. Baby, all I want for Christmas is
That's it from us this year. Have yourself a very Merry Christmas and hopefully this time a Happy New Year.
fingers crossed we'll be getting to see you all here next year. But thank you so much for the submissions and thank you so much for watching. Merry Christmas!
Kissing Santa Claus, and I'm gonna tell my